surface of the temporal lobe. These are known as the Hirschsprung gyri. And people say that this area of the superior temporal gyrus, especially the posterior part, is more wider in males than in females. This is nothing, the one superior temporal gyrus here, which dips into the stem, this superior surface. It has gyri. These are known as Hirschsprung gyri.
Right.
This is the hippocampus, which is this one, this projecting thing.
Okay.
Wait. I'll show you a better one. This should be the calcar ravis. Don't take this. This should be the portion of hippocampus. This is the calcar ravis.
That's the calcar.
This is the calcar ravis.
What's that?
I told you the calcarine sulcus.
Not the calcarine,
the collateral sulcus.
Oh, collateral sulcus. Mm-hmm.
This is the lateral ventricle. This indentation is of the sulcus, and this elevation, what you see, is produced because of that sulcus on the wall of the lateral ventricle. Let me show you the hippocampus. It's not in this specimen. No. I'll get you the other specimen. This is not a good specimen. Approximately this area here. But what you see here, that's the calcar ravis. This would be the region of the hippocampus here. Projecting down. This is the calcar ravis. This is the optic radiation. This is not a good specimen for hippocampus. Don't identify it in this one.
There's another name for optic radiation or something like
geniculocalcarine.
Yeah.
Crash.
Oh, okay.
What we did is, this is at the level of the insula. See, you can see this is the insular cortex, right? This is a horizontal section. So we just cut it horizontally like this, just above this stem. So that you can see this is the insular cortex, and there are two capsules, external capsule and internal extreme capsule. And this is the lentiform nucleus. So lentiform nucleus is in close proximity to the insular cortex. So basically, when you see the insula playing, it's deep to the insula are the basal ganglia. Alright? And the nearest to it, insular cortex, is this capsule nucleus, which is the lentiform nucleus. To expose this, we took this level. Alright?
So this part of it is the glomus pallidus.
Right.
This is the darker one, the putamen.
Oh. The lighter one in the center, that's the globus pallidus. Lateral one, that's the putamen.
And the layers, the capsules.
External capsule. Mm-hmm. Then you have the extreme capsule. Then this gray matter, what you see, that's the claustrum.
That's the claustrum.
And this surface, what you see here, actually it's broken. It's not a good specimen. If I were to take a fresh specimen, you can see a thin rim of gray matter here. That's the claustrum. And this, what you see, that's the gray matter on the surface of the insula.
Okay.
The claustrum is present here. You know, this is like too many times I've shown, so gone.
Okay.
So I'll take out sections from this brain.
Did we see the H-shaped sulcus on the
I didn't show you. Sorry, good to remind. See, that's the olfactory sulcus. This is the olfactory tract, and here what you see, that's the orbital sulcus. Actually, in different bodies, that's the thing about human body, you know. I mean, it won't be exactly the way it's in the picture. See, it's close to it though. Anterior, posterior, medial, lateral.
Oh, okay.
That's the gyrus rectus.
Okay.
It won't be exactly like a, you know, diagram picture, and each person has, you know, it varies, the shape of gyri, the size of gyri sulci varies in each individual. That's why you are doctors. You have to discuss our doctor.
Yes.
What artery is this?
Vascular
artery. What arteries are these here? Posterior cerebral. And anteriorly, what you see, these are the anterior communicating. This is the anterior cerebral artery here, okay. And internal carotid, you can see this is the lumen of the internal carotid. And coming from here, you can see this is the middle cerebral artery.
Okay.
This area we will have the circle of Willis. Alright.
Okay.
And you can see No, we don't see the vertebrals. If we were seeing the vertebrals, we'll see the spinal arteries emerging from the two vertebrals. Here, just at this sulcus where the pons ends and the medulla begins here, the two vertebrals will join here and they form the maxillar artery. Okay? So you have the olfactory bulb, olfactory tract, and then you have the olfactory stria, and in between them you have the anterior perforated substance. Then you have the limen insulae, which connects all these with the insula and the uncus here in the temporal. So these are involved in the pathway of the olfaction. All right? Because insular cortex is involved both in the pathway of taste as well as hearing, and also in the autonomic, the visceral perceptions.
Why is Heschel's name? Heschel's
Here, on the surface. These are large and small gyri are present on the insula. But the sulci which are present on the surface of the temporal lobe here, the one which is hidden, these are known as the Heschel's. These are cut actually. These are not so well appreciated.
The ones
on
over
this.
Here? The ones on the temporal?
Here. Okay. Yeah, on the temporal. Maybe in this specimen you can perceive better. These, what you see? Long ones.
Oh,
these
okay.
Ones. Here, on the temporal lobe. They are the
Heschel's.
Here on the surface of the temporal.
Okay.
Okay. All right. Thank you.